At one time, Gwyneth Paltrow was one of Hollywood's most famous actors. However, in recent years, she stepped back from the spotlight and devoted her energy to other endeavors. Here's why you don't see Gwyneth Paltrow on screen much anymore. In the aftermath of Seven and Emma, Gwyneth Paltrow was in high demand in Hollywood, and in 1998 alone, she released 5 movies: Great Expectations, Sliding Doors, Hush, A Perfect Murder, and Shakespeare in Love. Though Hush wasn't one of Paltrow's winners, the rest became fairly big hits. Sliding Doors is still one of her most popular and referenced performances. And of course, Shakespeare in Love won Paltrow her first Academy Award for Best Actress thanks to her role as Viola, a noblewoman who carries on a passionate affair with William Shakespeare. Paltrow suddenly became one of the industry's biggest names, following up her Oscar win with the crowd favorite, The Talented Mr. Ripley, in 1999. However, her huge awards win might have led to a bit of a professional downfall. After winning big for Shakespeare in Love, Gwyneth Paltrow's career floundered, and a string of critically panned and commercially unsuccessful films followed her famous turn as Viola. Part of that may have been backlash over the Oscar win, and even years after the fact, some of Paltrow's peers don't think she deserved the trophy. In 2020, Glenn Close discussed the win, saying, "I remember the year Gwyneth Paltrow won over that incredible actress who was in Central Station, Fernanda Montenegro, and I thought, what? It doesn't make sense." Paltrow herself has cast doubt on the win, saying it led to some bad choices. As reported by Reuters, Paltrow admitted, "I think part of the downside about being so successful and winning the Oscar at the age of 26 is that I sort of became insouciant about the things that I chose. I thought, oh, I'll just try this, it'll be fun, or I'll do that for the money. Things like that now I would absolutely never do." Obviously, curses don't actually exist, but it seems that the win may have gone to Paltrow's head and negatively affected her career. Aside from 2001's The Royal Tenenbaums, which is still one of Wes Anderson's most beloved films, Gwyneth Paltrow's post-Oscar film choices were definitely a bit suspect. That same year, she appeared alongside Jack Black in Shallow Hal, a romantic comedy about a man who starts seeing people's inner beauty. As such, while Paltrow's character Rosie is actually overweight, Hal sees her as Hollywood A-list thin. Though the movie performed well at the box office, its premise was offensive, even by 2001 standards, when it comes to body shaming and inclusivity. And it definitely hasn't aged well as the years have gone on. Paltrow later even called it a disaster. After that, Paltrow appeared in the 2003 flight attendant romantic comedy View from the Top, which Paltrow herself later called the worst movie ever, and followed that with 2004's Sky Captain and The World of Tomorrow, after her Talented Mr. Ripley co-star Jude Law enlisted her for a role. The film did perform well critically, but ultimately barely earned its budget back, adding to Paltrow's list of flops. Gwyneth Paltrow has taken on one hugely successful role in recent years that spans several blockbuster films: Pepper Potts in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Introduced in the film that kicked off the MCU, 2008's Iron Man, Pepper works as the assistant and confidant for millionaire playboy Tony Stark, played by Robert Downey Jr. After that, Paltrow reprised her role as Pepper in 2010's Iron Man 2, 2012's The Avengers, 2013's Iron Man 3, 2017's Spider-Man Homecoming, 2018's Avengers Infinity War, and 2019's Avengers Endgame. Pepper may not be a main character in the MCU, but she's vital for Tony's character development. However, despite her long-running arc as Pepper Potts in the MCU, Paltrow doesn't seem to think about those films very much, to the point where she often forgets she even appeared in them. In a now infamous moment from Jon Favreau's cooking series, The Chef Show, Favreau, who appears alongside Paltrow in 2017's Spider-Man Homecoming, reminds her of a moment from filming that movie, only for Paltrow to coolly inform her co-star that she wasn't in the movie.
"We weren't in Spider-Man."
Yes, we were.
"Homecoming.
You were in Spider-Man."
"No."
Between that and the fact that, according to Bucky Barnes actor Sebastian Stan, she keeps forgetting who he is and also doesn't seem to know who Tom Holland, who plays Spider-Man, is either, it definitely doesn't seem like Paltrow thinks about her Marvel projects particularly often, which indicates her acting career may not be her priority these days.
"I thought that it was an Avengers movie, but it was not."
"It was, I see, okay."
Gwyneth Paltrow is passionate about clean, healthy eating and high-quality food. In 2007, after her career had taken a bit of a downturn, Paltrow worked with PBS for Spain on the Road Again, which sent her to Europe to explore the country's cuisine. 1 year later, she released a cookbook on Spanish food with chef Mario Batali. In 2011, she published two culinary books, My Father's Daughter, Delicious Easy Recipes, Celebrating Family and Togetherness, and Notes from My Kitchen Table, and later followed those with her 2013 cookbook, It's All Good, Delicious Easy Recipes That Will Make You Look Good and Feel Great. However, Paltrow's move into the culinary scene was met with some controversy, especially over an elimination diet she promoted in her 2013 book, which didn't have a ton of scientific evidence to back it up. As recently as 2020, after suffering from COVID-19, Paltrow promoted a diet and routine to supposedly help long-haul patients with long-term symptoms. That diet was also critiqued by medical professionals. Gwyneth Paltrow took a huge leap in 2008 when she launched her newsletter Goop. After the official Goop website eventually launched, an online store was quickly born, and the critics descended upon the actress. They accused her of spreading bad scientific information as well as seeming utterly out of touch, as her gift guides often included prohibitively expensive items. Ultimately, it seems like Goop's critics were actually kind of vital to its success, with even its most ridiculous and bizarre products selling out regularly. Obviously, beyond its controversies, Goop is a huge project, which definitely cuts into Paltrow's time, and she cited it as a reason for frequent gaps in her acting resume. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more Looper videos about your favorite stars are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.